Hi everyone and welcome back to Lesson 8. In this chapter, we'll explore data tables and Excel scenarios for what's referred to as what-if analysis. What-if analysis is the process of changing certain values to see how those changes affect the outcome of formulas in an Excel worksheet. What-if analysis allows you to see what output results if the values of various input assumptions change. In this chapter, we're going to use two Excel tools to perform our various what-if analyses, data tables and the scenario manager. We'll start off in level 1 talking about data tables, then we'll talk about scenario manager in level 2, and then we'll do some more advanced simulation stuff in level 3. We'll use data tables when we want to ask a what-if question involving a range or multiple ranges of values. If you change the values in the data table, you'll get to see how that affects the output of your formulas from your worksheet. The data table will let us perform many calculations simultaneously and then let us compare the results of those by easily varying input values. The scenario manager allows us to consolidate the results of multiple what-if models into one worksheet so that we can easily compare them to each other to see which model is best and/or worst. Once you have those models established, we can easily switch between the different scenarios to see how the various sets of assumptions affect the results determined by our formulas. In this chapter, we'll conduct break-even analysis, sensitivity analysis, as well as create, format, and interpret both one-variable data tables and two-variable data tables. You can also create a two-variable data table to base a what-if analysis on a realistic probability of what will happen as opposed to actual data. Doing so is referred to as a simulation. For example, you can run a simulation to help analyze the expected profitability of the company, given various product sales, prices, and estimated probabilities of product demand. We'll get into that soon enough and go over some examples of that powerful tool. Now, the scenario that we're looking at in these videos is that the zone is looking to invest in a new kind of swimsuit, but before they make this commitment, they want us to analyze the profitability of the new proposed product called TZ Swim Skins. So let's begin at the beginning. What is a break-even analysis? It's a type of what-if analysis that concentrates on an activity at or around the point at which expenses of creating and selling a product are equal to the revenue that's produced, or in other words, where the profit is zero. At what point do we break even or start to make a profit? Here's an image displaying the results of a break-even analysis. You can see on the vertical axis, we have money in thousands of dollars. On the horizontal axis, we have the units sold of our new product. This red line that starts out at $60,000 represents our cost to make swim skins for each of the quantities sold down here on this axis. It starts out at $60,000 because that's the amount of fixed costs or overhead that exist just to open our doors for business. It represents the base salaries, the rent, the air conditioning, etc. Then as we start selling units, each unit also has a manufacturing cost or cost of goods sold associated with it, so as we sell more, our costs go up accordingly. Our other blue line represents the revenue that's brought in by us successfully selling the swim skins. It starts out at zero and goes upward at this rate. Assuming that we're selling items at a profit and sell each for more than we buy it for, then this line is steeper than the red line from the previous slide. At some point in our sales, our revenue line catches up with our cost line, and at that point, it looks like it's around 2,000 units. We've broken even, and our cost of $140,000 equals our revenue of $140,000. We've gotten all to that point just to break even. Below that point is the amount that you lose for a given amount that we sell. For instance, if we sell 1,000 units, it looks like our revenue is around $75,000 and our costs are around $100,000, so we lose around $25,000. Above the break-even point, this is where you want to be, allows you to see the amount of your profit. If we sell around 2,500 units, then our revenue is about $175,000, and our costs are around $160,000, so at that point you can see that we'll make about $15,000 in profit. Now let's look at a sensitivity analysis for our swim skins. Sensitivity analysis is another type of what-if analysis that attempts to examine how sensitive the results of an analysis are to changes in our underlying assumptions. In other words, as you change the value of one assumption, how do the results of our calculation react to that change? Let's look at a sensitivity analysis chart. Because what-if analysis typically involves many estimates and projections, sensitivity analysis helps managers learn how tolerant the projected results are to changes in our underlying assumptions about such things as cost, selling price, and quantities sold. For example, if we were asked how our projected profits change as we vary our selling price, our variable costs, and our total fixed costs by $1, we see how much of an effect that each of those individual changes has on our overall profitability. We see that a $1 change in our selling price for a swim skin has a 35% positive influence on our profitability. A rise of $1 in our total variable cost creates a 32% drop in profit, and a dollar change in our fixed costs has a 3% negative effect on our profitability. Now that we know what our break-even and sensitivity analysis look like, let's introduce you to the data tables. A data table is a range of cells containing values and formulas. When you change a value of an assumption, the data table shows you how that change affects the results from the formulas in your spreadsheet. Because you can compare the results of many calculations in data tables, they can be very useful when performing break-even or sensitivity analysis. Excel can be used to create two different types of data tables, a one-variable and a two-variable data table. Both types have input cells, which are the cells that contain values that are allowed to vary. They also have result cells, which contain the formulas that involve the input cells in their internal calculations. A one-variable data table has only one variable input cell and many result cells. It's awesome for showing the results of how changes in one variable affects the output of a formula. For instance, how much would we earn on an investment if we invested at a different interest rate varying between 1 and 20%? We could run our future value formula from Chapter 6 20 different times for each of those percentages and then record the values for each formula, but life is too short for that. That's why we use a data table. In contrast, a two-variable data table has, go figure, the ability to analyze the output of our result cell formula for changes in two variables. Building on our previous example, what if, in addition to wanting to see the results of our investment for changes in interest rates, we also wanted to see how it varies for changes in the length of the investment duration? Before we start working with an actual data table, it's important to know that a data table depends upon values and formulas actually contained on the same worksheet as a data table. You must structure that worksheet in a way that it contains input cells that contain the values that you want to modify in your what-if analysis. It should also use result cells that calculate the values from the input or assumption cells. In the next video, we'll review a one-variable data table that illustrates how revenue, expenses, and profit vary as the number of units sold varies from 500 to 5,000. See you in the next video.